Today I'm gonna talk about the trapezoidal rule and finding out the numerical integration in Python. So in this rule we want to find the integration of f of x within the interval a to b. So let that function is continuous on the closed interval a comma b, then this interval, closed interval, can be divided into various points, let's say n number of points using this formula, where this delta x is the width of the each interval. Here this x naught is the lower limit of integration and xn is the upper limit of integration b, and all the points lie between that a and b. So if we divide these points, then we can form so many trapezoids. The area covered by these trapezoids, and then if we find out the sum of the area covered by all these trapezoids, then we can get the integration value here. So this is what we are doing here. Here this delta x, like I told, is the width of the interval, and then f of x naught is the value of the function at lower point of integration, and then f of x1 is the value of the function at this position here. Similarly for all the values of x. So if we simplify this, then so for those who have the value of factor 2 as well, is separated here, and then that gets canceled out with 2, so we can write that in the form of this. And then for the two terms, this f of x naught and then f of x, and there is no any factor of 2, so this is separated in the first term. So now we have two terms, this term first term, and then this summation term second term. So this is the basics of the Python, trapezoidal rule. Now we can do this in Python. So what we need to do is we need to define this f of x and then find out the sum of that f of x in this limit where I runs from 1 to n minus 1, because this summation extends only from 1 to n minus 1, as x0 and xn are already excluded from the summation. So okay, let's do this in Python. So first we need to import the packages for that, so that we can get the sine of x into the Python. So to get the sine of x into the Python, we need to first import the package called numpy. So let's import this, import numpy as np. So this as np means simply I'm importing numpy in a shortcut as np. So when I run this, yeah, I don't have any error. But if you have not installed the numpy on your Python, then you need to install it first before using this. So you can do that just by writing pip install numpy. Since I already have this, and then shift enter, then yeah, it's gonna install on your Python. Since I already have this, it says requirement already satisfied. But if you don't have it and getting error, you need to do this. But I already have this, so I'm deleting this. I don't need that right here. Okay, so first I imported numpy package, and then now let us define this function sine square x, because I will be explaining about this example here. So my function will be sine square x, and this 0 is the lower limit, a equals 0, and then the upper limit of integration is pi, which is my b value here. So let me write the sine square x as a function. So to define a function in Python, we should write def first and give one space and write the name of the function. I'll write just f, which is the function of yux only. So give this, and then it should return the value of sine square x. So how to write sine square x? First, numpy sine x. This will give you the sine x, but we have sine square x here on our function. So put this in the bracket and then just square it. Squaring means double asterisk 2. So this double asterisk gives the power of that expression. Okay, I define the function f of x equals sine square x. Now, since we already have this question where the lower limit is 0, upper limit is pi, and then number is, the question says it's 6. So I need to change this as 6. All right, so yeah, let's define this. A equals 0, B equals pi. So how to import pi in Python? So it can be done using np.py. So this is the property of the numpy, and then find out the number, which is 6, and then delta x. I will define delta x as del x equals simply b minus a over n. All right, so we give value of a, b, n, and delta x. Now let's do the summation for that, because so first I will find out the summation and then finally add this term to get the integration value. So let me do the summation first. So to do the summation, I will use for loop. Okay, so let me give some random summation equals 0. This is just to define it before we use the loop. Okay, for I in range. So I need to define this I, like I told you earlier, I in the range from starting from 1 to n minus 1. But since Python only takes the values one step below than what you give here, so I'm giving n here. So this simply means Python starts from lower value, that means from 1 to one step lower than this value, which is n minus 1. Okay, so for I in the range of that, my summation will be summation plus what is the actual thing, delta x times f of xi. Okay, so delta x times f of xi. All right, so I already told you about this xi, which is a plus I times delta x. So you can simply write this is a plus I times delta x. All right, this will give you the summation times delta x. Okay, that means it just gives this. Now we need to add this quantity as well to get the integration. Okay, so summation is finished. Now let's get out of the for loop and then find out the integrated value equals, this should be, like I told you, it's delta x over 2 times this plus the summation. Okay, so it's delta x over 2 times it's f of f of a plus f of b, because f of x naught is f of course f of a, and f of x n is f of v. So this is delta x over 2 times f of a plus f of v, and then plus summation. This will give the integrated value for me. So when you do it manually, you can get the answer of this as pi over 2. So I just want to check whether my answer is correct or not, so I'll define the actual value as well. But at this point, let me print my answer. The integrated value using trapezoidal rule in Python is, okay, and my actual variable is integrated value. All right, let's see how it works. Okay, so I got this 1.57079 as the answer. So actually, the right answer for this is pi over 2. 5 means 3.14 divided by 2 is about this. So that means I got the right answer. All right, so let's find out if the calculated value is deviated from the actual value. Okay, let me define the actual value equals, it's pi over 2, and then let me calculate the error, percentage error, which is error equals, it's the absolute value of actual value minus integrated value over actual value times 100. This will give me the percentage of error of my calculation. And then let me print this as well. The percentage error of the calculation is, okay, it's the percentage error variable. Okay, let's see how much difference it has. Wow, this is awesome. So it's 0% at this point, because this is a simple function, so numerically also it gave the same exact result that we can get analytically. Okay, so this is how you can use the trapezoidal rule to find out the integration. How do you feel about this tutorial video? Please do write the feedback, and then if you need any help regarding this, you can write email to me, which is given in the description below. Okay, so I have included one problem as well. You can try this just like I did here. Okay, finally, this is my reference from where I took these problems. All right, thank you so much for watching this video. You have a good day. Bye bye.